little mini Patagonia road trip.
There it is, Hotel Xiao Xiao.
Really beautiful. Kind of secret atomic research laboratory.
See what else there is to see.
Conspiracy theories.
It's all collapsed in on itself.
Dare we go in? Welcome back, everyone, to Bariloche, Argentina. Today, we're going to do something. We're going to do something that we haven't done yet. On this trip, we're going to rent a car. That's right. We're renting a car, and we're going to go on the first part of a series of two videos of a little mini Patagonia road trip around the area here around Bariloche to see all the beautiful stuff you can see that you need a car to get to. So come along. Thanks for clicking on the video. If you want to help out the channel and help it grow, I really would appreciate it. Click on the like button down there, the subscribe button, and the little bell next to it to be notified for when new videos drop. It really helps the channel grow because it's going to help the YouTube algorithm recognize this content and spread it to other YouTube viewers. If you'd like to support the channel monetarily, I would appreciate that as well. You can leave a super thanks by clicking this thanks button here and give a small donation to the channel. I appreciate your support. So back to the video, enjoy. So for this entire trip, I've been basically like doing public transportation in any city that I go to. A couple of times, our good friend Charlie XP has chauffeured my lazy ass around. And other than that, just been, you know, flying from city to city or taking a bus. Had no need whatsoever to have a car, but out here in Bariloche, it's a little different. There's some areas outside of the city, out into the greater Patagonia region that you're just not gonna be able to get to unless you have a car. Now, theoretically, I could hire a car service, a remis, right? Have them drive me out there, but I kinda wanna take it a little more, like a little slow and a little more like improvised. I know what I wanna see out there, and there's a lot of great stuff to see, but we're gonna need a car to do it. So, right across the street here from the Alamo rental car place, we got a car reserved. We're gonna go pick it up now, and then we'll hit the road. All right, so we did it. We got our car. It is a Citroen. I've never driven a Citroen before in my life, but this will be a first. I've also never driven a car in a foreign country before, so this will also be a first. But so far, so good. Next thing we need to do is we need to go get gas, because the car didn't have very much gas in it when I got it. I had it reserved, and I need one with an automatic transmission. And the only one they had didn't have very much gas. But that's no big deal. We're gonna go hit the gas station on the way out of Bariloche. And we're gonna head out to the west to what's called the Circuito Chico. It's basically like a little loop that you can take that goes, I don't know, like in amongst a national forest, La La National Forest, and a couple of other like really beautiful little lakes. There's just a lot of stuff to see along there, and we're gonna go check it out. But first things first, we need some gas. We got our gas. We're all gassed up. We're ready to rock. Get a nice view of the car here. Our Citroen C3 Aircross. It's pretty nice. It was a little bit dirty and it was low on gas because they didn't have the automatic transmission that I had reserved, which was like a small car, like a little compact car. This is actually much bigger, so it worked out better. We got the same price. The car is going to be, you know, dirty anyway, because we're going to be driving it like out into the wilderness, so to speak. And we end up with a full-size car and only paying the compact car price. So I think we're going to hit the road out here. We're going to head down towards El Circuito Chico. On the way, we're going to stop at a bunch of places. The first place we're going to stop is this little beach. We're actually right here on the lake. Get some beautiful views of the lake. But there's this little beach down there. Like before you hit the Circuito Chico. It's called Playa del Viento. The beach of wind. And it looks like it's just off the main road a little ways. So we'll go check that out before we get onto Circuito Chico. Made a little stop before we get to Playa del Viento. Here we are at Playa Bonita. Beautiful beach. And it is a beautiful beach. But I wanted to stop here because right there, out in front of us, that is Isla Huemul. Huemul Island. And I mentioned this in the first video that we made here, but that island is super interesting. Why? Well, because back in the early 1950s, in the era of Juan Perón, the Argentine government built a kind of secret like atomic research laboratory right out there on that island. Now the story is, in the years following World War II, there were a lot of German scientists who made their way over here to Argentina, and one of those was a guy named Ronald Richter. And he was an Austrian-born German physicist who had convinced, many people, including Juan Perón, that he would be able to unlock nuclear fusion technology, right? And fusion technology, the ever elusive nuclear fusion, you know, unlimited clean energy technology. And Perón was so convinced that he built, right there on the island, a very, very large compound with multiple buildings, building like a reactor building where they could build an atomic reactor, and Richter would be able to carry out his experiments and generate fusion, nuclear fusion. Now, they were so confident about it that there were news articles published in like 1951 that Argentina had achieved atomic energy. But it turns out Richter was kind of a fraud, and actually later, after he did not develop nuclear fusion, and after Juan Perón was deposed, Richter was charged with fraud. And right there on the island, I don't know if you can see, there is like a little dock right out there. And the buildings are still there. In fact, up until recently, it was like there were tours that went out there and you could tour the island. It's all abandoned. All the buildings are abandoned. Some of them are collapsed. And you can still actually get over there. There's just no guided tour. Technically, the island is closed off. But if you want to, right here on the beach, you know, you can like rent a kayak from one of these places down there and like kayak your way across if you want to, or if you have a sailboat, or you know someone who has a sailboat, or any kind of boat really, you can get out there to that island and you can check it out. It's not something we're gonna be doing, at least not this trip. Maybe if we come back to Bariloche at some point, we'll put on our Crocs, we'll get in a kayak, and we'll float over to that island, and we'll check out all the abandoned ruins of the Huemul project, as it's called. But for now, we'll just look at it from over here on our little road trip. And I think now it's time, after getting a quick view, beautiful, beautiful lake, we'll head back up to our car and get back on the road. We've reached Playa del Viento, or Viento. We've reached the beach, and there's this little parking area here, which is very convenient. There's our car over there, and let me tell you, the road getting in here was a little rough. It's unpaved, and I'm very glad, actually, that we didn't end up with a little compact car. We ended up with that thing, because even though it's not like a four-wheel drive or anything like that, it's got much higher ground clearance than like a little compact car would. So going around bumpy, rocky dirt roads, it's actually quite nice. I think if we go this way, this will take us down to the beach, but man, you can already see these beautiful views. Now this lake that we're on here is a different lake. This is, what's the name of it? Perito Moreno, I think. Lago Perito Moreno? I think that's right. If I'm wrong about that, I'll put it in the subtitle, but I think I'm right. And this whole area around Bariloche, other than, you know, like the huge lake that Bariloche is on, Lake Nahuel Huapi. There are a bunch of other lakes around here. Glacial lakes. And that's what this is. Man, this view is so beautiful. Look at this. This is gorgeous. Beautiful Andes Mountains. Beautiful lake. There's like a boat launch here, so you can take your boat out on the lake if you want to. There's a few people hanging out here on the beach, but for the most part we have it all to ourselves. So beautiful. Anyway, we're gonna be heading down that way, and I don't know if you can see it. Basically, like, right there, there's a little bridge at the other end of the lake. And that bridge is kind of right near the what is going to be the end of the loop, the Circuito Chico, in the direction that we're taking it. So we're actually going to go up along there, take the Circuito Chico all the way around, and loop back and cross that bridge right before we come back onto the main road to get back into Bariloche. It's really, really, really peaceful here. It would be really nice to have one of these houses right here on this lake. I can only imagine how expensive it is to live here, but so beautiful. Anyway, got a good view. Good view of this beautiful beach on the beautiful lake here. I think we'll hit the road. The next place we're going to go is a little village outside called Villa Laulau. And Villa Laulau is interesting. I mentioned it, I think, in the first video that we made, that they built a hotel out there. The government, when they were building the buildings in like the center of Bariloche, and also the cathedral in Bariloche. They also built a hotel out here, specifically for like tourists, a resort hotel called Villa Lau Lau. Really, really cool old looking hotel, very cool architecture. So we're gonna check that out. Right across from there, there is a beautiful like viewpoint, a mirador, right? Where you can view out into, not this lake, maybe the same lake. I think it is actually the same lake, but it's on the other side of the bridge there. I'm not sure, but we're gonna check both of those out. For now, head back to the car. There it is, Hotel Xiao Xiao. I realize I've been pronouncing it wrong. I've been saying Lau Lau, but it's Xiao Xiao. And there it is, the beautiful mountain range behind. We're down here on the road, but we're gonna drive up, see it up close. All right, we've arrived up here at Hotel Xiao Xiao. Right up there, very beautiful. Out here in the parking lot, the security guard let me park for just a few minutes just to take pictures. They have flags of a lot of different countries. And I want to get a look of the building up close. The architecture on this building is very cool. It's that sort of Alpine style architecture like they had in the buildings in the center of Bariloche, because this was constructed by the government under the same project at the same time back in like the 1940s. Really beautiful, super cool hotel. It's a very expensive resort to stay in too, so I'm not going to be staying here, but man, it's beautiful. And it's situated, if I can walk over here just a little bit, it's up on this beautiful lake, another glacial mountain lake. This, I think, is also the same lake we were on at the beach. This is Lago Perito Moreno. Beautiful view of the mountains out in the distance. Obviously, it'd be a very, very nice place to stay. The Hotel Xiao Xiao. But for us, I'm just gonna see it from the outside. Man, it really is cool though, the architecture. I can really appreciate it just from seeing it from the outside. I imagine inside it is quite lavish. Very cool. Very cool thing to see. I think it's neat that the government built all of this as like specifically as a resort, specifically to attract tourists. And still, of course, Bariloche is a very, very popular tourist destination, not just for tourists from other parts of the world, but for people from Argentina, coming from all over Argentina, like 1 million people a year, mostly during the winter for skiing and whatnot. But there's plenty of stuff to do outside of the winter as well. So let's go back down. We'll head across and see this little mirador, the little viewpoint that's right by here. Right here, just across the road from the Hotel Xiao Xiao, you can see up there, there's this beautiful little, it's almost like a little ferry launch. It's this little peninsula that sticks out. You can see up behind the building there, the trees up on like a little hill. And we cut through here. You can see beautiful, beautiful views out here on the lake. And lots of boats. There's like a little mini marina over there where people can park their boats. And it looks like there's some sort of like larger pleasure cruise kind of boats. But man, look at this. This is beautiful. I'm gonna be saying that a lot, and I've already said it a lot, obviously. Everywhere we go along here, right, in this whole area, is just gorgeous. And like I think I mentioned in the first video we were made while we're here, this is actually a national park. This is Parque Nacional Nahuel Huapi, named after the lake, the large lake. But the whole thing is like a national park. That's one of the reasons why, like, the government were the ones that built Hotel Xiao Xiao and the buildings in the centro of Bariloche. The whole thing was a planned development. And of course, there were, you know, settlers here in Bariloche and in the area before the modern planned development. But the reason that it is the way it is now is mainly because of that development that happened in like the, you know, mid 20th century, right? Like the 1940s or so. Anyway, right here, as part of Parque Nacional Nahuel Huapi, there is like a little building that I think is like a cafe maybe inside. I hope so. It's about lunchtime and I'm getting kind of hungry. I also need to find a bathroom. So let's go check this out and see what's in here. So there was a cafe in that building. An offensively expensive cafe, but we're in a tourist attraction, so that's to be expected. But right here, around the back of the building, up on that little hill out on the peninsula that we noticed, there's stairs. We can go out to like a viewpoint. Next up, we're gonna go to Villa Tacul. A little bit further up the road, there's a very, very interesting and very kind of mysterious thing out there that I wanna see. I'll talk more about it when I get there. All right, we're here deep in Xiao Xiao Forest. Took this very sketchy dirt road that kept getting sketchier and sketchier all the way down out to the end of this peninsula called Villa Tacul. And as you can see, we're in the forest. I wanted to come out here because, one, I've seen a couple of videos where other people have visited out here, and one, there's a beautiful beach basically right here through these trees, which I want to see. But additionally, there is a mysterious collapsed structure out here, way out here on the tip of this peninsula. And there are plenty of conspiracy theories about what exactly that structure is. Damn, this is beautiful. It's actually right out there, I think, on the other side of those trees. It's where the structure is. Now, some people say that it was a hotel that the government was trying to build, or someone, a developer, was trying to build out here, that got abandoned and eventually collapsed. Some say it was a military bunker that was built out here, but strangely, it's a weird place to build a military bunker. There's no strategic reason to have a military bunker out here. We're not like, we're close to the border with Chile, but not anywhere close enough to have a bunker. So the conspiracy theories that abound about this collapsed structure are that it was a bunker built for Nazis who were fleeing Europe in World War II, after World War II. Now, I already know from some previous videos that there were several prominent and a lot of not so prominent Nazis who fled to Argentina after the war. One of them lived right here in Bariloche, Erich Priebke, and was discovered here, living here in like the 1990s, by Sam Donaldson, the US journalist. Now, the real big conspiracy theory is that this bunker over here was built for Mustache Man himself, and that Mustache Man didn't actually die at the end of World War II. That he fled here, you know, in disguise, incognito, with his girlfriend, Eva Braun. And that they lived here in Bariloche, or around here at least. And that this bunker over here, or whatever it is, was, yeah, like a security bunker for him. I don't know. I don't know what it is, honestly. I've researched, tried to figure out definitively what this thing is over here, and I have no idea what it is. I also don't know how to get to it. I think maybe up through here. Let's take one last look at this beautiful view as we go deeper into Yao Yao Forest, because this might be the last thing we see, who knows. Let's head up this way and see what we can find. Come to a larger trail. That's reassuring. Right or left? Left. All right, left was the right choice. Because here we are. It's all collapsed in on itself. You can see it was pretty significant, pretty strong structure. Lots of very thick concrete with rebar all through it. Right out here on the tip of this little peninsula, as you can see, it's just surrounded by ocean, or I mean by the lake all the way around. Dare we go in? I think we do. I'm very tall. I have to crouch down. Far too tall for this in here, but yeah, you can see there's plumbing and everything in here. Definitely can't go through that hole. But man, it's definitely a very serious structure with these concrete floors. And even though it collapsed on itself, you know, the floor here, still solid, still standing. crazy. Let's climb back out, try not to hit our head. All right, we're back out. So of course that conspiracy theory about Mustache Man, that's one that's been it's been floating around for, well, pretty much ever since the end of the war. The theory that Mustache Man actually survived, and that the body that was found in the bunker in Berlin was like one of his body doubles. I don't know, seems kind of far-fetched. I think it's one that they like to talk about in regards to Argentina, just because there were actual high-ranking, you know, Nazi SS members who ended up here after the war. Juan Perón's government was pretty sympathetic to Nazis and set up basically a pipeline that they called the Rat Line to sort of hide and smuggle high-level officers here to Argentina. Now, it should be noted, definitely not the only country that was doing this. The United States and the Soviet Union scooped up as many high-level officers, scientists, anybody they could get their hands on. And they didn't do it because they wanted to punish them or, you know, bring them to justice. They did it because, like, for example, Wernher von Braun, the scientist who designed the V2 rocket and the rocketry programs for the Nazis during World War II. That's the guy that really, like, led the space program for the United States rocketry and getting to the moon eventually in the 1960s. So, certainly not an isolated thing to try and shuttle Nazi scientists and officers into your country for the intelligence and the skills that they had. But Mustache Man, I don't know. I don't buy it. I think Mustache Man died in the bunker in Berlin. And this, I don't know what this is, honestly. I really have no idea. But it's something that we see, and from here we can get a beautiful view of the surrounding area, which is just gorgeous everywhere you look. Anyway, now that we've seen this, I think it's time to get back on the road. We keep on going around Circuito Chico. See what else there is to see. Well, we've made it around the other side of the lake here on Circuito Chico, and there is Villa Lau Lau and the, or Xiao Xiao, and the Xiao Xiao Hotel. At the beginning of the video, we visited Playa del Viento, and here is Playa sin Viento, the beach without wind. And where we mentioned that off in the distance, there was a bridge, and that bridge was right before the sort of end of the loop, Circuito Chico. Here's the bridge right here. Beautiful views from the bridge. Right down here on the other side, the Playa Sin Viento, the beach without wind. Very beautiful. Where we are, right to the end, right at the end of our loop here, our Circuito Chico. Once we make the turn right up here, we're gonna be heading back to Bariloche, and it'll be, I don't know, about 10 minutes drive, and we'll be back in Bariloche. So I think that's gonna be it for this part of the video. Like I said at the beginning, this is gonna be a two-parter because I want to take a road trip a little bit further away. I want to head down south on Highway 40, which we are going to do in the next video. There's a lot of beautiful stuff to see along that highway, a lot of like little towns along the way. We'll end up, I don't know, a couple of hours south of Bariloche, so we'll get a little further away and we'll check it out as we continue our mini Patagonia road trip. So stay tuned for part two. Hope you enjoyed part one, and we'll see you next time.